It's as simple as something that nobody knows it. Her eyes are as big as a bubble.
Sunny Santa Barbara, a place to relax at the beach, surf, take a walk, and enjoy the beauty of nature. And although the beach is beautiful, nature can have a sticky side. In Santa Barbara, the sticky side is tar. My name is Rachel Frazin, and I am a student doing environmental research at UC Santa Barbara. For this research project, I interviewed students about their knowledge of the local tar phenomenon. So what is tar? Most people just know it as the black stuff that gets stuck to your feet.
I do know what tar is.
What is it?
Some type of oil substance.
Like oil residues from the oil spill?
Scientifically, tar is derived from the wood and roots of pine. Throughout history, tar has been used for numerous purposes, including waterproofing roofs, boats, and ships. The Chumash Indians, natives of the Santa Barbara area, would utilize their natural resource of tar and use it for paving and other ceremonial purposes.
I think it comes from an oil spill that happened, I forget how long ago.
The oil spill was a consequence of the offshore drilling industry in the Santa Barbara Channel. There were adverse effects from the spill, including the death of marine animals, such as birds and seals, as well as a temporary suspension of commercial fishing. But overall, the long-term environmental effects were minimal. Offshore drilling began as a controversial issue and is still debated over today. I wanted to talk to an oil expert, so I found Dr. Ira Leifer, a researcher at the Earth Science Institute and Marine Science Institute at UC Santa Barbara.
I mean, I think tar is a... I think it's important for people to realize that tar and oil are both part of the natural system here in California and other areas where there are geologic reservoirs, which within a certain constraint are natural and not a pollution problem, and yet within another level of emission from oil spills and so on become a very significant environmental problem. This is an area where human and natural efforts overlap, and better understanding of this kind of a system prepares us for understanding and mitigating what happens when large oil spills occur, such as the one that occurred recently in the Gulf of Mexico. So I think we should look at the tar as sort of, and the oil that associated, one of nature's wonders, but also a dangerous one that we need to be respectful and careful with. Some of the tar, in some locations one can see tar that's become asphaltized, adhering to rocks. And that tar could be very old, and some fraction of that could relate to the oil spill. Certainly none of the fresh tar could be more than probably a few weeks old. It would most likely just a few a day or less old. And in general, even on those rocks and other formations, the vast majority of oil would have come from the seep field. The 69 disaster was terrible, but it occurred only once, whereas there has been every day a continuous flux of tar and oil to the beaches and then away from the beaches, stretching over, well, decades, centuries, and the geologic record shows at least 500,000 years the seep field has been seeping.
So the oil spill did have an effect, but this tar isn't going away. This is why I decided to team up with Ira to do a research project on tar and its effects on our surrounding environment. I wanted other students at UCSB who were interested in environmental issues to be involved as well, so I hired some students to help out with the project. These students went out to Coal Oil Point near Sands Beach and measured the tar accumulation in the area. This is done using tape measures and data sheets. The tar is classified into different size categories, and the counters record how much tar of each size is visible on the beach that day. This is repeated an ongoing process because tar accumulation differs from day to day. Once this data was collected, Ira and I analyzed all of the data that has been accumulated since the project began in 2006. We searched for seasonal patterns, patterns of wind and swell speed, as well as wind and swell direction. Understanding the tar patterns throughout the seasons can help organizations like the Coal Oil Point Reserve Snowy Plover Program with their management of the endangered snowy plovers. This program strives to rehabilitate the snowy plover population by protecting beaches. Knowing which parts of the beach accumulate the most tar would be helpful in their mission. Researching the patterns of tar at Coal Oil Point has been going on since 2006. My project is a continuation of research done by Dr. Ira Leifer, Tanya Del Santro, and Daniel Culling. I sat down with Daniel to talk about his experience with the project.
My favorite part was, as an undergrad, being able to work outside and learn basic scientific principles, but just challenge my own abilities and my own accuracy. I was familiar with the presence of tar and had taken a history class that explained that the Chumash Indians used it for their boats, but other than that, I really had no experience with it whatsoever.
Daniel's experience showed me that working on a research project as an undergraduate can teach you important skills and lead to future opportunities in the field. I wanted to find out the experiences of the other students working on the project as well.
It's interesting to see the lasting environmental impacts that we have, and to work getting to monitor that was a pretty cool experience. And so each day the beach would look different, each day the environment would change a little bit, and so each day was a new experience.
My favorite part of the job was seeing all the sea life and how it changed with the seasons. Even though sometimes we had to count around some dead crabs or something else of the sort, it was still really cool to see all the sea life that can exist right next to our little town of Isla Vista.
It was really great to be able to work on the beach and to be able to kind of give something back to Isla Vista.
In the end, the information we collect from this project helps us understand a fundamental process on Santa Barbara's beaches and coastal waters. Without knowledge of our surrounding environment and the natural processes occurring, we would be unable to protect and sustain the beautiful place we live in today, as well as protect it for future generations.